In the following video, you're about to see a guy who claims to be a Muslim but doesn't believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, nor follows the teachings of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, nor does he believe in the hadith, nor does he prescribe to the religion of Islam, though he does believe in the Holy Quran. Is this possible? How does this work? We are about to find that out exactly on today's video. So without further ado, how are you guys doing today? I hope you guys are doing great and I hope you guys are doing well. Before we get started on today's video, do me a favor, drop a like on the video, leave a comment as well, telling me if you agree with the guy who's gonna say that he doesn't believe in the Prophet Muhammad or he doesn't believe in the Hadith, though he believes in the Holy Quran and he says he's a Muslim. Or do you agree with the other guys who are clearly Muslims who are telling him he needs to repent and he is wrong? So let's not waste any more time. Let's go and let's get it.
Enlightened Truth TV.
Friend are rejecting the Quran now. So not even a Quran.
No.
Okay, anyway, I think we're wasting our time.
So rejecter of Quran.
If you love Allah, you follow the messenger. He doesn't follow the messenger. He asked the question, where is the messenger? And then this is
now
this is
what I would expect from a non-Muslim.
Music is haram. He said it, brothers. Listen to him.
Listen.
Music
is haram. The last
that's
question.
The Quran. How see, our come to Allah and the Rasul, he keeps banging on about the music.
I love Allah and I will
show him
the
verse about
how
the music.
How do you follow the messenger?
I'll tell you right now.
Go on.
Can you let me finish? 10 seconds.
Yeah, go on.
The companions and the people around the messenger follow the messenger.
Yeah, but how will you follow?
I follow strictly the Quran.
No, how will you follow the messenger?
The Quran, even the Quran, how did the Quran come to you? How did the Quran come to you?
You're mistaken.
Wait,
if you love Allah, you
gotta wait. How did the Quran come to you? Wait. How did the Quran come to you? How did the Quran come to you? How the Quran was preserved to come to you? How?
Memorization.
Who? Memorization of who?
The people.
The people.
The same people who brought the hadith to you. Do you know that?
Yeah, and the same people that Allah said it's easy to memorize.
Oh, have you memorized it?
No.
So how do you know it's easy to memorize?
No, it's just easy. It doesn't say you must, every single Muslim must memorize it.
How many surahs have you memorized?
I know,
so you've memorized more music than surahs?
No, I don't know.
You don't memorize any music?
No.
I find that very difficult.
I listen to it.
If you're so obsessed with music, you must have memorized some music. Come on.
Can you take back?
How about Baba Baba Black Sheep?
Music is haram. Take it back. Music is haram.
Bro, learn to perform salah.
You cannot prohibit music when Allah did not prohibit it. That's haram. That's haram.
How much zakah do you pay?
How many what?
How much zakah
do you pay?
You know zakah, right?
Okay.
What's the...
You brothers are perfect Muslims, yeah? Take it back.
Can you please answer the question? How much zakah do you pray?
Don't prohibit music.
You already answered the question about music. Stop being obsessed.
But you look
very
childish. You know Allah.
Look,
you know Allah.
I did not say I was Allah.
Okay.
But Allah told you, atiyu zakah. So, atiyu salah wa ata zakah. How much zakah do you... Atiyu salah wa ata zakah.
I don't believe
in it. How much zakah do you pay?
I don't believe in the percentage. I believe in the overall charity that Allah commands.
So how much overall charity do you give?
Generally speaking.
How much?
I don't know, just when I see someone I
So how about if you give less than what Allah has wanted?
So wait a minute.
Allah says, wait a minute. God,
what happened to your collective?
Do good, pray,
collective,
Salah.
Yeah.
What happened to your collective understanding of the rulings of Allah? You said you follow collectively what the Muslims do on Juma. Why do you not do the same with zakah?
For zakah.
It's not sincere.
You know what I said earlier?
Sincere.
You cannot even follow the five pillars of Islam if you don't follow the hadith. You become like him. Pick and choose.
The Quran is
and
the primary
all he does
source.
Is about
the Quran is the primary
music.
Source. The Quran is the primary source.
But you don't follow that either.
I'm good.
So you don't even follow
one
that.
One second. If the hadith says something and the Quran goes against it, you will say...
Show me an example.
No. I'm saying...
Show me an example.
No. I'm saying, for example...
The hadith, the Quran, the hadith can never contradict the Quran.
Are there inauthentic hadiths?
Unauthentic, yeah. That's why they're being called unauthentic.
Exactly.
By the way, do you think we follow unauthentic hadith?
No.
Exactly. So why bringing that up?
I'm bringing that because at some point someone had
anyway,
to say,
look, like I said, you can't follow the five pillars without the hadith. And you being a hadith rejector, on Yawm al-Qiyamah, you'll have to answer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, if you love me, follow whom?
The messenger in those times.
Assalamu alaikum, brother.
You added to the Quran.
How are you?
So you changed it in the Quran.
I came from far away to watch you guys.
Barakallah.
Where does it say that time in the Quran?
Okay.
Did I lie? I watch you all the time on YouTube.
Barakallah.
Why did you lie about the Quran? Did you not say at that time?
No, I didn't say it.
On camera?
No.
Okay, anyway.
That's what I use my time on. Like a lot of time, actually. MashaAllah, you, all of you, MashaAllah, you're doing great work, MashaAllah. Jihad, this is a true jihad.
Barakallahu fi.
Stop stammering now.
Because you of course, I'm learning as well from you guys.
Yes, where? In the hadith, the scholars disagree.
Learn to read the surah first.
Okay.
Before you go to music. Learn to at least memorize maybe 10 surahs, you know? Not just two. If you know only Fatiha.
Should I follow the hadith entirely? Can you follow the hadith entirely?
Authentic hadith.
It's impossible to follow the hadith entirely.
Authentic hadith.
How many books
are there? Okay, which part of hadith is embedded?
You have to follow every single page.
Tell me one hadith that is difficult to follow. Go on.
Ours was a Muslim friend, yeah?
There you go, there you go. And here it is. About music. Finish him with the music.
Says to walk everywhere.
This is for the music.
You cannot follow every single thing from
but ask him first if it's amusement.
Okay, you cannot follow every single thing. It's impossible.
Have you tried?
Brother, it's so impossible.
Have you tried? You can't even follow the salah. The hadith about the salah, you can't even follow that.
No.
How can you expect you to follow anything else, my friend?
No, you said
you follow collectively. That's nonsense. Imagine this. There is a place where they collectively pray the salah in the wrong way. Not according to the problem.
What about Shia Masjid?
You guys need Sunnah. You guys need.
By the way, read this Quran.
Is the Quran protected?
You bang on about music, read that.
Is the Quran protected?
Is the Quran protected? Yes, it is protected.
Okay,
read this.
Is the Hadith protected?
Yes, it is.
No, Allah did not say
read this. Read this.
Because he doesn't specifically say.
Read this.
And of the people is he who buys the amusement of speech to mislead others from the way of Allah with our knowledge and who takes it in ridicule. Thus, we have an humiliating punishment.
What is that about?
It says, all of the people is he who buys.
Let's see what he's going to say about amusement of speech.
You don't understand English, you wouldn't know. So what language do you read your Quran in?
English.
But you said you don't understand English either.
Brother, I don't understand. You're putting me on this spot though.
You're putting him on this spot.
You know, I bring up many such ayahs, and you say I don't understand English. So now your problem is not just Arabic, but also English.
I understand now. He says who buys the amusement of speech. I don't follow speech, I follow the Quran.
What is the amusement of speech?
And that is
what does it mean, amusement of speech?
Like you're entertained by what people say.
Huh?
You like enjoy.
So you're saying you think I'm amused with what you say?
No, it's amusement. You're amused at speech.
How are you amused?
How are you amused?
Amusement of speech. When is it amusement? With speech. With music.
Amusement of speech. Music. Yes, music.
Honestly, you know, I pray that Allah gives you
hidayah.
Here in the Quran, you mappe.
Basic English. Because you don't even understand the Quran.
It's a mappe.
Brother.
It's a waste of your time. Salat al-Asr. Did you pray Asr?
Zina is haram. Pork is haram. Alcohol is haram. However, music is not haram because it's not mentioned anywhere in the
Quran. He just read it. He didn't over your head.
Boom. Amusement of speech.
What else can it be?
It's a basic English.
That's speech.
Which speech? Your speech. Definitely not amusement.
Speech.
Oh, you got amused by them?
No.
Why call it amusement then?
You know what's the synonym of amusement?
You know, I think you were right the first time. You did not even understand the English. You were right the first time.
MashaAllah, brothers. Let's finish the video.
Stop pushing me. Come
down.
Whose microphones are these?
Okay, now it's time for me to weigh in on this video, right? It's time for me to weigh in on it. Here's the thing. You cannot claim to be a Muslim. You cannot claim to be following the Holy Quran if you are not following the Hadith, if you are not following the five pillars of Islam. You cannot claim to believe in anything the Quran say, if you disapprove or disbelieve in the messenger that Allah sent, the messenger in whom or with whom we have the Holy Quran that we have today, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, even going further, you saying that music is not haram, but all of these other things that you are naming are haram, alcohol, fornication, all of these things that you are naming are haram, but the amusement of speech, which is music, something that is very, very much powerful, something that can entice you, something that can amuse you, something that can even bring about certain spirits upon your life and, you know, call upon certain spirits upon your life, you saying that music is not haram becomes an issue and becomes a problem. Because if you believe in that, you cannot believe in the five pillars of Islam. You cannot believe in the message that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to preach. Because if you believe in his message, you believe in the Holy Quran. If you believe in the Holy Quran, you believe in the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in that order, you will reach a point of trying to learn or trying to memorize either surahs of the Holy Quran or reading into detail the hadiths that we have right now in the religion of Islam. This video is a total, complete waste of time because this guy, he doesn't know anything about Islam. He is not a Muslim. He's just a guy who read the Holy Quran and decided to go to Speaker's Corner to try and lie about it. Because if you asked him to state or recite one verse, one surah, he would have failed. That's the end of today's video. Drop a like on the video, leave a comment. Much love. Peace out.